Joining us now, our NHL Network insider, Elliotte. Good to see you. Freshly shaven Elliotte Friedman. I know all summer we've been chatting with a very shaggy beard. When did that go away?
It went away the day before Labor Day, Jamie, but as one player in the league has already texted me, he said, "You look better with half your face showing than the full one."
Ouch. Don't we all love those fun interactions? Let's get to the news of the day, and that is that Connor McDavid is still not 100%. The rumor has it that he's going to be sitting out at least the preseason. What's the latest, and will we see him opening night when the Oilers take the ice?
Jamie, I think Connor McDavid would like to be ready for the start of the year. I mean, you've got two players next to you. You never want to miss games. The start of the year is one of the most fun times of the season. And also, look, they're a team that hasn't made the playoffs recently, and or not especially, they haven't a lot over the past decade of their franchise. He's their cornerstone player, and he wants to make a difference. He wants to be ready for the start of the year. I think organizationally, though, however, they look at it as, we have to be smart with this. This is our franchise player. This is the best player in the National Hockey League. And I think they just look at it like, we can't be stupid. And I think it's going to be a little bit of headbutting, the player wanting to play and the team wanting to be careful. I don't think the team's going to let him go out there until they know that he's got no risk of re-injuring it based on the work that had to be done at the end of last season.
Wow. Well, we certainly hope for a speedy recovery, because it would be a shame if opening night comes and, like you said, the best player in the NHL right now is not on the ice. We are still waiting to hear, too, whether another top young star will be on the ice, and that would be Mitch Marner with the Toronto Maple Leafs. Camp opens tomorrow for the Maple Leafs, and yet there is still no deal. What can you tell us in terms of the latest updates with that situation?
Well, Jamie, it's bananas here in Toronto. I live here in this whole city for the last 24 to 48 hours. There's no shortage of opinions on where this is going to go. It's been reported in the last couple of days that the Maple Leafs had a 7-year, $11 million average annual value offer on the table back in June. That was turned down. The Marner side responded with a 3-year deal that would have a $15 million number in the last of those three seasons. And that way the Leafs would have to qualify him for the next year at least $15 million likely. And that would walk him right to unrestricted free agency. And they didn't want to do that. Now, I had one general manager say, "You guys are supposed to be insiders." And that's been 3 months ago it happened. It's about time you figured it out. But I think that shows you just how far apart the two sides have been all summer. So this really got out in the last couple of days. It's not going to be easy for Toronto to do this now because of their cap situation. They've got some key players, Hyman and Dermott, that will be out at the beginning of the year. They've got some players they've got to put on long-term injury. They traded for David Clarkson's contract as a bit of protection. But I'm not sure cap-wise, without making more moves that they probably don't want to make, they can still do 7 times 11. I think they're looking at a 3-year deal. I think they're looking at a 6-year deal. But Mitch Marner wants to be paid on the same level as Austin Matthews. The organization doesn't want to do that. I think at the end of the day, it's going to be up to the player. What does he want to do? What contract is acceptable to him? And if the status quo is not acceptable to him, this is going into the season.
Very interesting. As the hours continue to pass and the days and weeks ahead, we still continue to wait on news there. Meanwhile, just over to the west in Winnipeg, we do have a signing to report. Josh Morrissey, we just talked to him on the phone about his new 8-year deal to stay in Winnipeg long term. What do you make of this?
Well, I think it's a great deal for the Jets. I think he's a really talented player that's just coming into his own. You know, Winnipeg wanted to do this last summer. They wanted to sign Josh Morrissey to a long-term extension. He said no. He went for a shorter bridge, a 2-year deal, and it worked out great for him. I think he's a really talented guy. And I think the thing is, too, is it's been a little bit of time in Winnipeg. They had to trade Jacob Trouba for cap reasons, and also Trouba wanted to go to the United States and a situation he's talked about with his wife and her career. Tyler Myers, they lost him too as a free agent to Vancouver. They're having trouble signing Kyle Connor, who wants term, and Patrik Laine, who doesn't. This is just a win for the organization in the sense that hey, here's a guy who's a young player who's a big part of our team, and he wants to be here. I think that's, hey, it's a great contract for the player. He's going to make $50 million. It's a great contract for the team because it gets Morrissey a term. It's a win-win for both sides.
You mentioned Patrik Laine and Kyle Connor, both RFAs with the Winnipeg Jets. Where do those negotiations stand as of now?
I don't think they're really in great spots. There was a report today that they offered Laine a deal at $5 or $6 million a year. You know, for a two-year deal, that's pretty big for a two-year deal, but Laine is going to want more. I don't think he wants term. I think he wants something short. Connor, I do think, wants term. He's willing to sign there for a long time, but he's a scorer, and scorers get paid in this league. So I think Winnipeg is in a situation where they're in a bit of a squeeze. They're trying to make this all work, but I think the other thing that's happening here too, Jamie, is that I think a lot of players are waiting for Marner. When Connor McDavid signed his big deal in Edmonton, and nobody's arguing that Connor McDavid isn't worth that money, I think there were a lot of players that said, okay, I'm not as good as Connor McDavid, but I'm not $6 million worse than Connor McDavid. It elevated a bunch of other players. I think a lot of them were looking at Marner and they say, look, if he hits that big number, 10 or 11, I think other players are going to hope it elevates them too. And I think that's kind of where a lot of players are in a bit of this holding pattern.
Yeah, we are still in that holding pattern, and I keep waiting for these dominoes to fall with training camp underway. So, yeah, we'll continue to check in with you. Before we let you go, we just mentioned Logan Couture being named officially as captain of the San Jose Sharks. Sounds like they're going to go with a couple of alternate captains as well. What do you make of Couture and his new role?
Well, I think it's a great choice. You know, first of all, you know, I think if you take a look at that team, you know, they've been dominated by, you know, guys well into their 30s, Pavelski, Burns, Thornton. And, you know, those guys are still very big forces on that team, great players. But I think it's interesting that they give it to a guy who's maybe a little bit younger to take that show into the future. But the one thing I like about Couture is he loves being a Shark. That organization means a lot to him. He cares a lot. He's determined. I think he's a guy who's got a great attitude about playing, and I'm not surprised he's the captain. I have no doubt he'll do a great job at it. I think he's a fantastic choice.
All right, great stuff as always. Thanks, Elliotte, for the time. I'm sure we'll check in with you soon. Again, hopefully in the next couple of days or so about all of these RFA situations.
So I hope something actually does happen so I can stop making it up and give you something concrete.
Here. Perfect. Well, hey, you know what? You make it up with the best of them. Thanks, Elliotte.
Thanks very much. Thank you.